emotions coming in.
Yeah, self-awareness is key. I think when I start to see those telltale signs, so I think for me, one of the things that creeps up the first is maybe sensitivity. If I feel that every kind of ebb and flow that life is sending my way is really impacting me, that's a real sign for me. So my way of dealing with that is to disconnect. So I will take some time out. So say, for example, if work's been really busy, then I'll make sure that I kind of schedule time every single day to rest and recover and recharge, even periods like now where it's really busy, having that time just to kind of immerse in yourself and recharge. But also not being afraid to turn down stuff. I mean, we're living in a Zoom world at the moment as we record this in December 2020. But if I'm going to be on Zoom all day delivering, the last thing I want to do is a quiz with my friends on the night. I don't want to be doing that. Having that courage to say, actually, no, I need some of my own space. And actually, it does take courage sometimes, especially in a busy household. Mm-hmm. You need to start to ring fence that time. So I'll go and immerse myself in something which is a healthy distraction. So I like gaming, for example, I'm a big gamer. I love to do that. That kind of distracts me for a little while. But again, too much of that may take me the other way.
Yeah.
So it's recognizing that the things like sleep or exercise and nutrition could be out of kilter as well. So it's kind of like you go back to basics. And a lot of what I do in terms of a speaker, but also as a mentor as well, is focusing on that high performing day, that kind of that playbook that's uniquely yours. So I love country music and not everyone does. So actually that will motivate me. It will probably kill a lot of people to hear that kind of stuff, but losing your doggy and missus. But that kind of thing, you need to know what's good for you and what will change your state in the fastest way possible. I think that's really the secret. We cannot control the uncontrollable. We cannot control pandemics, other people, what they say, what they do. All we can control is how we proactively choose to go into each and every day. I think the danger is that when we look at things like mental health, if we're struggling, choice is the first thing we sacrifice.
Yeah.